you found respect for people who decide to stay at home? Because I think the definition of success is different for every person.
So that difference over the last 5 years, we've actually brought back an additional 750,000 women back to the workforce, and that has contributed about 0.3% additional GDP growth per annum.
Time is up to you, and as long as I know I'm doing a good job, I'm fine. So I need to be able to be more efficient than I was before.
I guess the biggest challenge is the guilt, but that was in the 30 years. The guilt, both sides actually, guilt that I'm not spending enough time with my children, guilt that I'm not spending enough time with my team at work.
But then again, you know, I just realised that this career is a long-term journey, right? So it's okay, I mean, I'm going to get there, I'm just going to do it at my own pace and what works for me.
Sure. And there are some organisations that we worked with where, you know, they are recognising that that's an issue.
Once they find something that works, it will scale up. This is something that's valued, something that we need to really put in place.
The other stuff is to have a mentor, again, a formal mentor, someone higher up that will champion for you.
Whereas someone who's coming back after a career break is probably more likely to be a stable talent pool.
Well, firstly, you need to have passion for the work that you do. Obviously, you need to love what you do. I think a lot more other women were a lot more confident to ask for this sort of flexible work arrangements. You know, if you love what you do and you have the support of the people you work with and the support of your family and your spouse, then that's what it takes to make it work.
But I think the bigger issue is not so much on the policy front. I think it's really at the mindsets of a corporate Malaysia.
How do you manage your work-life integration, especially with your family?
So what happens to the pool which is in between?
I don't feel guilty now when I have to go home at 6 o'clock.